Big launch today from Nvidia. Ah, what excitement, what turmoil, new graphics cards, 1,000 preparations, an embargo, making sure not to let any tests or benchmarks slip onto the internet, a lot of precautions as if they launched nothing more or less than the 5000 series. But no, they launched this, which is pretty much the same as this. Well, not exactly, but not far off either. So, what's the big deal? Today Nvidia announced three new graphics cards with the super name, which will replace, well, I'll tell you right away what they will replace. Jokes aside, the news of the day is as follows. Nvidia launches the 4070 Super, 4070 Ti Super, what a jingly name, and the 4080 Super. Personally, I wouldn't dare call it a proper launch, despite the noise Nvidia has made on this subject, but rather a refresh. And the equivalent models, namely the 4070, 4070 Ti and 4080, are from this moment end of life, meaning they are discontinued. Is that good? Is it bad? We'll see immediately. What I have received here is the 4070 Super in the Founders Edition version, which looks exactly like the 4070 FE present here, except that the Super version is completely black. And that's it, we put an end to this video. You feel the sarcasm, right? Okay, the second thing that irritates me about this refresh is, how shall I put it delicately, the begging for attention. They made a reveal at CES as if they were launching the Enterprise Shuttle and not a range refresh, and they also set a stupid staged embargo. Today I am allowed to announce them, show them, talk about specs and prices, and that's it. Then, only next week, am I allowed to reveal tests with the 4070 Super. In the following week, we are allowed to test the 4070 Ti, and then, at the end of January, we are permitted to reveal results with the 4080 Super. So Nvidia is trying sneakily to turn a pretty ordinary refresh into a big deal, and to obtain with one refresh exposure as for three full-fledged launches. And I'm seriously considering not giving them this satisfaction, and after today's presentation, to do a roundup of tests with all three graphics cards at the end of the month. Take that, Nvidia. Of course, I wouldn't be surprised if after that they would cut us off from samples for not playing by their rules. So, from my point of view, the Super Series is a storm in a teacup, and Nvidia is doing everything in its power to stir up a disproportionately large amount of attention compared to the intrinsic consistency of this launch, for obvious commercial reasons. Probably also because there is a long way to go until the launch of the 5000 series, so Nvidia is trying to obtain a stage victory and not let the interest fade away. That's why they also packed this presentation with a lot of blah blah related to AI and additional technologies, but these new graphics cards are ultimately what they are. A 4070, a 4070 Ti and a 4080, with X percent more powerful than those they replace, where X is not very large. I had a long discussion with Nvidia officials about these models, and even they admit without reservation that the Super Series pulled out of the hat today is in no way an upgrade for those who already have a similar graphics card from the 4000 series, but are clearly targeted towards those who are still on graphics cards from the 1000-2000 series, or weaker models from the 3000 series. As for those who own top models from the last mentioned series, like the 3080, 3090 or 3090 Ti, the selling point of the new 4000 Super cards would be this, that they offer similar or better performance than those with lower consumption and bringing additional technologies that those do not support. But beyond these commercial considerations, what are the cards really like? Or more exactly in the singular, what is the card like? Well, let's see. So therefore, what you see here is the 4070 Super. It's a small card, I would dare to say even elegant in this founder's version. It will occupy little space in the case and strikingly resembles the 4070, which, as I was saying, it doesn't complement, but completely replaces. From the standpoint of construction and design, the two cards are absolutely identical. They have exactly the same components, the same weight, the same dimensions, with a single notable difference. The 4070 Super is pitch black, as opposed to the 4070, which has these shades of metallic gray. Otherwise, it stays the same. And now let's take a look towards what we are allowed to reveal, namely the specifications. It is interesting, but also predictable, that in the discussions I had directly with them, Nvidia was dead set on comparing the 4070 Super with the older models with a 70 in the tail, that is the 3070 and 2070, and not with the 4070. Okay, understandable as long as they themselves admit that the new model is an update, and that's about it. And now let's talk numbers. The 4070 Super naturally comes with the same 5nm Ada architecture GPU manufactured by TSMC, with the same 12GB of GDDR6X video memory, and with a slightly higher consumption than the outgoing model, 220W instead of 200. But let's take a closer look at the specifications. When the new graphics cards were presented to me, there was thus a wonderful comparison, with massive increases in core counts, flops and VRAM. Except that, as I said, the comparisons were made with the 3000 and 2000 series. The second smokescreen was the fact that the physical changes were not announced, such as the number of shader cores, tensor cores, etc., but only changes at the level of theoretical performance. Based on this information, but also on what has been leaked in the last few days, let's look at the RTX 4070 Super compared to the RTX 4070. The memory remained the same, with the same speed, but we notice a theoretical increase of up to 24% in performance, in the context of an increase of only 10% in TGP. Such a large increase in performance cannot be put down just to frequency increases. And if we look at the information already available on the internet, we can confirm the increase in the number of cores. At least according to these figures, the RTX 4070 Super is perilously close to the older RTX 4070 Ti and represents a promising start for the new lineup. For the 4070 Ti Super, the increases are somewhat more modest, only 10%, but the selling point for the new card is not here. More important for many is that the RTX 4070 Ti Super receives 16GB VRAM, finally distancing itself from the RTX 4070. According to my calculations, the memory bus itself has changed from 192 to 256, because you cannot address 16GB of RAM except with a bus that is a multiple of 16. If my calculations are correct, the memory speed has remained the same, 2625MHz, with the memory transfer speed increase of 33% being strictly due to the increase of the bus. The maximum graphic power remained unchanged, so the 4070 Ti Super is more efficient than the card it replaces. Unofficial data at the time of making this video seems to confirm this deduction. And finally, let's look at the RTX 4080 Super, because here we see the smallest increases, about 7% up in theoretical performance. All the increases for the RTX 4080 Super can be explained by a slight overclock, but it does not seem to be the case, because the TGP remained unchanged, 320W. What does the internet say? That we have a small increase, 5%, in the number of CUDA cores, and an almost insignificant increase in base and boost frequencies for the GPU. Most likely, Nvidia has also tinkered with the voltages, so as to fit within the previously mentioned maximum power. And now, let's also talk about prices, because here comes the bombshell. RTX 4070 Super and RTX 4070 Ti Super will be launched with a recommended price identical to that of the cards they replace. Moreover, the RTX 4080 Super will have a recommended price even lower than that of the RTX 4080, and not just by a few dollars, but by 200. What has gotten into Nvidia? This generosity is not characteristic of them to give more performance for the same or less money. So where did this pricing scheme come from? Well, let me tell you my suspicion. From AMD. The RX 7800 XT, which I talked about in a previous video that threatens the RTX 4070 Ti, has a recommended price of $500. After this update, the 7800 XT will compete with, and most likely lose, to the RTX 4070 Super. Similarly, the 7900 XT, which exceeded the RTX 4070 Ti and was a threat to the RTX 4080, has a recommended price of $900. Therefore, the 4070 Ti Super takes a step forward in terms of performance, and although from my estimates it still will not reach the level of the 7900 XT in classic rasterization, the price of $800 will somewhat remedy the problem that the 4070 Ti had in comparison with the Red Camp. In the case of the 4080 Super, an internet commentator put it quite well: RIP 7900 XT and XTX. Even if I wouldn't be so radical, the massive price drop for the RTX 4080 Super will hit both the RX 7900 XT and its bigger brother, the 7900 XTX. However, let's be clear, at an identical price, the RX 7900 XTX remains without a doubt faster in classic rasterization. Nevertheless, if you take into account Nvidia's technologies, the clearly superior ray tracing performance and more stable drivers, the balance does not tilt so much in favor of the Radeon card. So, the overall picture is starting to clear up. The new models seem to have a dual function: to settle scores with AMD, especially in terms of price-performance ratio on one hand, and to entice user of older Nvidia cards to upgrade on the other. That's why Nvidia insisted in the one-to-one presentation we had with them the other day on the comparison with the previous series. Compared to the 3070, at the same consumption of 220 watt, this 4070 Super offers more of everything. More memory, more cores, and they say double the overall performance. Of course, we will seek to see for ourselves if these claims are justified, but we will not be able to do that until next week, given that we have signed this blood oath of silence regarding the actual testing. Then, the 4070 Ti Super finally abandons the 12GB VRAM of the model it replaces, a problem I pointed out about the Ti from the start, and comes with a much more decent amount of 16, while keeping the price unchanged. Good for them. And last but not least, the 4080 Super, which does not jump too far from the 4080 in terms of performance, but it comes with a massive price drop, which finally makes it truly desirable. In conclusion, and from my point of view, this Nvidia Super launch is more of a mixed bag. 1. It's a refresh, and 2. It corrects some initial judgment, price and positioning errors. You realize that we will come with more details, as we will be able to reveal concrete results in synthetic tests and games over the next 3 weeks, at the rate of one piece of card per week. Because that's how Nvidia wanted it, to stretch the hype a bit longer, thus benefiting from 3 times more exposure. Quite an insolent strategy, if you ask me, and even if this Super series undoubtedly has good parts, such as prices, some specifications, and certain performances, it is not so significant as to deserve 3 separate NDAs. And now, tell me down in the comments section. With these few pieces of information that we have at the moment, how do you find these 3 super models? What do you think Nvidia is pursuing with them? What is the intention, the purpose of these launches? I look forward to your opinions in the comments below. We end here. Subscribe please to Technic Qualities, and see you next time.